All right, what is up, everyone? Here we are, another beautiful day in paradise. It's a little rainy out, but it's a good day. It's another beautiful gift, but I gotta unload some of the Keep Life, the rest of the Keep Life from the car that I got yesterday. Just unload everything we got in here, actually. All this stuff, all this gear we got. I'm using a GoPro today. I'm just feeling it. Ben gave me a GoPro to use, and I'm just feeling it today. So that's what I'm using. Back here in the Keep Life room. It's actually really getting filled up already again. Gonna need to do another flea market soon. But just wanted to show you guys this weather vane. I know I showed it last night in that video, but I just think this thing is awesome. Probably one of my best finds. Trash picks in a while. Because I haven't been fully trash picking. I've been doing a lot of Keep Life from foreclosures, but back in the trash picking game, flea market dreams demand it. So also this little red tricycle and that gas can were all in that find, so not bad. Also look at this, I didn't show this yesterday. It's a replica of $100 bill from the Republic of Hawaii, but if this was real it'd be worth like $25,000, I think I looked up. But it's not real. And then I found this pocket knife. Let me see if this thing even opens up. It opens. This is a dollar or two item. Pretty cool. And then, oh, another thing I wanted to show you was this is a Girl Scouts like food tin here, and it's got the little Girl Scout bag on it, and that's for cooking and eating. And then there's like the Holly Shores Gypsy Weekend patch, and then Holly Shores Girl Scouts Gypsy Weekend 1969. So that's pretty cool. Found those in the same spot too. All right, we're rolling out from the house now. We're gonna go check out Ben's surf off, Wheel of Surfing for Thanksgiving down in Atlantic City. Yeah, it is south from here. Is that true? No, it's not. Now I don't even know, but up or down, either way. But yeah, an AC, and then we're gonna go maybe to a couple of thrift stores, and then we're gonna go check out and see if my mom needs any help, because Thanksgiving is tomorrow. And we might go to Smithville, possibly. And hopefully we find some gold along the way. So it's always a good thing to keep your eye out for treasures and scrap as you're going from city to city, because you never know what someone's gonna throw out or give away. So that's the claim today. The dream continues though, boys. Tell the claim.
I don't have one.
You got one.
I don't have one.
Sammy J is wearing all thrift store clothes right now for the dream.
All thrift store.
And she's making it look good, boys. Right? Stop it. No hands in the shot. What's your claim right now?
She's wearing the sweatshirt I wanted.
Dude, so you guys could never see from here because it's too far away. But that lady right there is wearing the Ed Hardy sweatshirt that we pulled out of that Wildwood house and gave to that dude on the street up here. And she's fully rocking the same sweatshirt. I mean,
looks way better in it than I ever would.
The problem is that sweatshirt was so outdated that there's no fucking way that someone else has that same sweatshirt. It has to be the same one.
Yeah.
And it's a 2 blocks away from where we gave it to the boy. That's too classic.
But yeah, we're in AC right now. The dream, boys, the dream.
Why is this thing so cracked out?
Key. There's a little Kiki, but he's running away. Hi, sweetie.
He's so cute. Down here. Heavy. You're a jack pig down here, killing it. Is that the iPad 8?
Yeah, I got a new one.
Here, I brought your hat.
Plus. Oh my god. This
and
is
the
so
shipping, sick. Money back, because that would just be crazy to make you pay for shipping that you didn't get.
That's not a big deal. But thank you. What's up?
For the boys down here.
Can hear if he's pumping.
All right, heavy crew down here for Ben's wheel of surfing. What's this thing called?
What?
What is this event?
One minute, Ben, 1 minute.
Sector Ben Surf Wheel Extravaganza.
But if you guys want to see what it actually is, obviously you can check out it on Ben's YouTube. So that's not hard to find. What's your claim?
It's a heavy one out here today.
Really heavy. Are you surfing or no?
Nah.
Just shredding the gnar.
I didn't make it. I didn't get the invitation.
Where is it? Dude, I was about to look in this dumpster, but what is that? It's literally just leaves.
Should be ready to go.
Alright, we're at the Smithville Village here in Smithville, I guess. It's next to Galloway, but they got all these like little boutique shops, and if I can remember correctly, they have a couple antique shops. So we're gonna see what we can find here, if anything. What's your claim? Look, there's a little rock right there. Thanksgiving rock.
Don't be mean, so stop. You're gonna make them run away.
No, I'm not. The cute donkeys. Come back here, thank you. The boy. Doesn't he look cool?
Yeah.
Alright, we're at the Days of Old Antique Mall. I think we're in Smithville still. But this is the baby. None of the shops actually where we just were antique shops, so I didn't even film anything really. But this place is like an antique mall, so we're gonna check it out. I've gotten stuff here before for my mom, for my dad, but they have a lot of vendors in here, so it's kind of for the dream. This for heavy. Vintage pistol. Some old school cameras. These lenses don't fit on mine though. Never do. Never find the newer ones.
just like that wooden thing. Comics. Old Playboys are like six. They're claiming six each. These are older than the ones I have, though. Not bad, though. Old golf sign. They're asking $1,500 for this, which is, I mean, you're not, it's not that easy to find these things, so. Old license plates are going for $20 for these ones. Hey, where'd you go off to?
Look at me.
This is a coin counting machine.
This is your mom's cups.
Sarcophagus.
Right? These are the cups your mom has.
Yeah, they are. Look at this thing. What'd you say?
I was looking more for clothes.
You don't like this stuff, though?
Oh, that's cool.
Look at this. There's like a little coffin for a baby. That's what it looks like.
It's a box.
Okay.
Look how cute.
A classic.
Yeah.
Look at this mask and this boots. Really, honestly, cool. And this piece. You're saying yeah, yeah?
Oh, cute.
And he's laying his neck down.
He's looking under the chair.
This is like a newer piece, too. It's really cool. It's like a new vendor, it looks like. Or they're leaving. Oh, I thought that was metal. It's wood. They got some clothes here.
You just wear that naked.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, this is real.
It's expensive, probably, too. Come in here and price match things that I have or have had or will have in the future, because I have some of these at my house in a little worse condition than this, so they're claiming like 40, 35. So the ones I have are probably worth like 20, 25. So you can just tell from that. Like I sold one of these for $2. They're claiming 22 in here. This is in way better condition though, but still, I could have gotten like five at least for it. Intriguing picture, you claim?
Yeah. Because it's a woman that doesn't have a, I guess, to our society, a perfect figure. I
don't think you'd see one of those hanging out there.
Somebody's house. The Honeymoon Killers. She's a
killer? It says the Honeymoon Killers. What is that, a band? Or it looked like a wrestler.
Shirley Stoller? Or is that just...
I think that's her name, yeah. Who would ever want that in their house? You have to have a mansion to have any of this gear.
This is fucking cool.
So epic. Imagine the shit in here. Look how cool this is.
$4,000. Get the fuck out of here.
The boy's face. Yeah, but no one's gonna buy that.
Red and Stimpy.
The cartoon, the comic. Wanted to look at this booth though for a second.
Stay asking these places is just out of control though.
My mom collects clogs, if you guys didn't know already. But 35, honestly too pricey. If they were like 10, I would get them.
We know, honey. We know.
What do we know?
We know if they were 10. These are cool, really as cool. Fuck, Macy's. With the
how
little...
How much are they?
$5.
Don't you kind of need them?
I kind of need them if they actually fit my big ass head. Oh. Are these supposed to be ear warmers?
Yeah. For the Macy's parade. They probably gave them out there one year. Gold miner. Painting for gold. Acres of diamonds, boys. It's all hand painted though. It's really cool.
It's a cello.
Cello. This is for like the lottery thing. Like bingo.
Yeah.
And then you got one of the balls on here. Are you price matching right now?
Yeah.
Alright, we have this elephant right there. And
same
I had
exact one.
This Hess truck before too, and I sold it for like $2. And this thing's probably for like 60. But you just can't get the same prices like this at Flea Market Life. It's not, it's a totally different game. Alright, I got a call about 15 minutes ago, 20 minutes ago from my boy Ed. And his claim is that his girlfriend's cleaning out his girlfriend's garage right now. And it's on the way back to my house, literally off the road, like a block. And I don't know, he said there's a radiator or something in there. And some other building materials is the term he used. But I can't pass up an opportunity for Keep Life and stuff I could make money off of, so I'm going there right now, and we're about to check it out. Totally for the dream. What's your claim?
Claiming you're like South Jersey's number one scrapper.
That's the claim?
Yeah, that's the claim. Yeah, I don't know.
Dude,
I mean,
heavy, boys. Heavy crew here.
Could you use this?
Oh, yeah, I'll scrap that for sure.
We got a radiator in the
garage. Take any of this metal, dude, and that extension cord.
There's an extension cord.
That's what I'm saying.
What's up? How you doing?
Good.
Some baseballs. What is this thing?
I have no idea.
I don't know.
Like a gym floor or something. That's what it looks like.
This is pretty great.
Yeah, I'll take that for scrap life. This is like hidden back here. When you said behind Tigris, I was thinking like, yeah.
Yeah, this is my girlfriend's house. It's pretty nice.
Dude, heavy claims. This is her papa's house? I want that, yeah.
Yeah,
I might have to come back for it though, because I might have to bring something to cut it up with.
This thing?
Because that thing's like 500 pounds. He doesn't want this?
No.
Oh shit, yeah, this is the nice one, easy one to take apart though.
Okay.
Yeah, I know. Because you can cut these little things, and then you hit it with like a chisel, and you split them in pieces so that I can take it out of here like piece by piece. But I'll definitely take that. Maybe not today though.
Okay. And what about this?
Yeah, I want it.
What the hell is it?
It's roofing material, I think. I'll definitely take it though. These two?
Yeah, I don't know.
Is this struts for a car?
Leaves and Springs, yeah, isn't that?
I think
that
so,
is,
right? Like, yeah. Are you moving into this garage?
We just want to clear it out. I just want to be able to put a car in here, you know?
Yeah.
Because
best case scenario.
It's just full of shit. So.
I'll definitely take this shit for now. Anything that's metal, I'll take. So, whatever's going.
Right.
Like that light, I'll take.
How about the window? Do you use that shit?
Is that? Maybe.
I'm gonna keep that saw. That saw's sweet.
Yeah, I'll take it. This thing is sick, huh?
Yeah, I'm definitely.
That's real
that.
Old school.
That's antique. So it still works.
That's cool. You can definitely use it. Or for a gimmick. I'll take this that light though, if you don't want it.
Where at? Right here?
That metal light, yeah.
Yeah. I don't know how we're gonna get that down, but we'll figure it out.
Easily, probably. Alright, I'll throw this shit in my truck. The dream.
Thanks.
What's
for
the claim?
Through. The claim is that you're, you know, this YouTube scrapper sensation. That's basically it.
That's good for business, though.
Yeah, it is.
Call up the boy, get rid of your shit. But yeah, thanks, though, for real.
No problem.
Peace.
This little baby doggy. Come on.
So this is what I'm claiming. It pays to be the guy around town that people know want junk. Because I just got an extension cord, two baseballs. Those are kind of like cell life. This stainless steel bowl, whole box of nails. I got this mirror, which could be cell life or keep life. This piece of strap that has some transformers in there and some wire. Big ass AC unit. And then I got box of these fake bricks that people use for construction. Probably a $10 value or something if I don't use them myself. A hinge to a door, and then two full 5-gallon buckets of nails. The case to the AC unit, and then I got a whole spool of aluminum roofing shit. And then these two struts from a car is what I think they are. Unless they're blades to something, but I think they come from the bottom of a car. So that's just scrap too. But that's the score I just came up on for the dream. Just cruising down the street and look at this scrap dreams I just came up on. Gotta get it.
Oh, you missed it,
bro. She hated that hat. We just tried to put the hat on her and she did not like it, but the boy does. Damn, that's how you have to deal with all the time?
I never have. That got weird quick.
She doesn't like me.
She doesn't like the freedom to dream.
The mesmerizing flow of the big jumbo dryer. All right, we're down here, over here at the laundromat, getting our about 3 loads we're drying right now. So it's a little bit easier to do it like this than to do it one load and a small one at a time, because we got like over a week's worth of stuff getting done right now. So it's pretty nice, but you know, it makes you realize the little things in life are important. Like just coming down here and getting your laundry done, it's relaxing. It's a nice thing to do. The mediocre parts of your life are sometimes the most enjoyable, to be honest. Tomorrow is Thanksgiving, and you know, it really gives you an opportunity to sit down and think about what you actually are thankful for. And I would say my girlfriend Sammy, my family, my pets Arlo, you know, the amazing life that I've been given and all the opportunities I've been given to, you know, do things my way in life instead of, you know, listening to a boss or bowing down to a system. So I feel really, really fortunate that I've had such open-minded people, including my parents and my family and my life, that allow me to think the way I do, because the more and more you look around, the more and more everyone's so consumed by just getting through life, and they're too busy in the rat race to even realize that they're in it. So it's just, it's really an amazing feeling. I was saying it's an amazing feeling to be able to live life the way I do and to just be open to realizing that you have to seize the moment and be part of something greater than yourself, and to just live your life and not be too caught up in what's going on and so caught up in the system and trying to please others and please, you know, others and getting a real job. And I don't think I'll ever do that. Look at this stinky. But we're gonna be going home and going to sleep after this, so I'll just end the vlog off right now. The dream is real, it's out there. Just chase it, boys. You know, keep pushing is what I'm claiming. And also what I was saying just a minute ago, you really have to find other people that think the same way as you and latch on to them, because if you don't, you'll put yourself in a situation where you're judged to, you know, be a part of the system. But if you find people outside the box, like Sammy and me, we can just vibe and just be happy with our lives, living day to day how we do, instead of trying to impress a greater thing that's not important in the end anyway. So latch on to those people around you that you can, that are important. It's important to do that. Latch on to people like-minded, because if you don't, you know, it can be too late later. But we're out of here for the night. Vlog's done. Tomorrow's Thanksgiving, and I'll be filming another video, obviously, so I'll see you guys in the morning for some more claims. You. Hello. What you doing?
None yet.
All right.